हाउ आर यू? टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू चैप्टर नंबर 4 इन बायोलॉजी. सो इन दिस चैप्टर वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट द रिप्रोडक्टिव हेल्थ एंड प्रॉब्लम्स एंड स्ट्रेटजी. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी वांट टू नो व्हाट इज मीनिंग ऑफ रिप्रोडक्टिव हेल्थ. अकॉर्डिंग टू WHO, रिप्रोडक्टिव हेल्थ मीन्स टोटल वेलबींग इन ऑल एस्पेक्ट ऑफ रिप्रोडक्शन, दैट इज फिजिकली, इमोशनली, बिहेवियरली, सोशली. इट मीन्स पर्सन फिट इन ऑल एरियाज, दैट इज कॉल्ड फिट. एंड इट मीन्स रिप्रोडक्टिव हेल्थ इंक्लूड ऑल एरियाज ऑफ जनरल हेल्थ. सो वॉट आर द प्रॉब्लम्स वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट रिप्रोडक्टिव हेल्थ? वॉट इज नीड टू लर्न? बिकॉज इन केस ऑफ इंडिया सेवरल प्रॉब्लम्स लाइक अर्ली मैरिज, हाई मैटरनिटी रेट, हाई मैटरनल एंड इन्फेंट मोर्टेलिटी रेट, देर इज लेस अवेयरनेस, पुअर पीपल एंड रिस्क ऑफ STD, दीज आर मेजर प्रॉब्लम्स. सो हाउ वी कैन इंट्रोड्यूस अबाउट दिस? सो वी नीड टू लर्न अबाउट लिटिल हिस्ट्री. इंडिया वॉज अमोंगेस्ट फर्स्ट कंट्री इन वर्ल्ड दैट इंक्लूड फैमिली प्लानिंग इन 1951. फैमिली प्लानिंग ऑल्सो पार्ट ऑफ रिप्रोडक्टिव हेल्थ. रिप्रोडक्टिव हेल्थ इन ए सोसाइटी फॉर्म ऑफ क्रूशियल पार्ट ऑफ जनरल हेल्थ एंड इट इज इम्प्रूव सेवरल काइंड ऑफ प्रोग्राम. सो वॉट काइंड मेजर आर टेकन बाई गवर्नमेंट through the help of audiovisual ads, print media, family members, close relatives, teachers and other members of society. Awareness needs to be provided. Sex education was introduced in school at different college and school. Proper information about the reproductive organ, adolescence, relative changes, safe hygiene, sexual practice, sexual transmission disease, etc. are provided through adolescence education program. So after understanding all these things, we need to understand some more important things. So in on the basis of above matter, we can say reproductive health is required in our society to learn about this required in our society. Amniocentesis is one kind of technique where amnion fluid can be taken in, from uterus, and this fluid can examine on the basis of chromosomal pattern to identify the growth of child and it is normal or abnormal. But it is misused by identify of sex, it is male baby or female baby. So in such way it is banned now, it is not used. Another method also available in market, that is ultrasound sonography. Same kind sonography also used to determine the embryo development, but some people are misusing such kind of technique. So it is punishable measurement. And now we are going to learn about population explosion and birth control. So regarding the population, what I am telling you, the population is increasing day by day because very simple manner. Population why increasing? Because the facility are increasing, the maternity mortality rate are decreasing, infant mortality rate are decreasing due to available of medical facility. And it is good we are providing day to day life medical facility and nourishment through Anganwadi centers, etc. So what kind of steps are overcome population explosion using various contraceptive methods, educating the peoples, increasing the marriageable age females and males. In India it is 18 and 21 years, but now government is planning it is hiking up to 21 year in both, providing an incentive to parents having one or two children. There is incentive by CBSE if single girls said it, and there is free of cost education up to 12th class, and if two children in couple in government employee, there is incentive is provided. So how we can control the such kind of situation, population blast, there are such method, contraceptive methods. Why these are used contraceptive methods? Because we need it. And an ideal contraceptive method should be user-friendly, easily available, effective, reversible, no side effect, and no way interfere with sexual desire and sexual act. So if we know about the different kind of methods, these are natural or traditional method, different kind of barriers, IUDs, oral contraceptive method, injectable, implant, surgical method, one we are going to learn. First of all, we are going to learn about natural or traditional method. So what are the natural or traditional method? Natural methods include only such methods, for example, lactation amoria, when fetus is taking the milk, the mother can't be pregnant due to high level of progesterone in blood. And for example, when we are using safe period, it means high risk period is 10 to 17 days of the menstrual cycle. So if we avoid such risk period, safe period can be used, there is little chance or less chance of pregnancy. Or Bidra method of coitus interruption method of one kind of method, where we can eject the penis from a vagina, just ejaculation of sperm. But these methods are usable, but some people are not liking these because such kind of condition can't be possible, and these are long lasting, sometimes these are failure. So other methods also available. I am telling about barriers. So what are the barriers? Barriers are protecting, these are working as a layer between vagina and penis. So first of all, I am telling about condom. Condom is available for both male and female, but it is popular in male condom. And other material like diaphragm, cervical gap, but these also barriers, different kind of barriers which are used in the female reproductive tract. But these are not popular in India. Some another things are available, just spermicide creams, jellies, foam, which can use such kind of barriers to destroy the sperm in surface. So what are the methods of such barriers? They are disposable, they are can't be self-insertable, they may be reusable, male condom can't be reusable. And one more interesting things regarding this, because regarding this, what I am telling, these barriers can be reusable, but most important thing, these barriers can make safe regarding the STD sexual transmitted disease. This is most important features of this. So next one, intrauterine devices. These are inserted by doctor or trained nurse or female in female of uterus. These intrauterine devices mostly formed by copper, for example copper T, lips, loops, or some IUD having the hormones, for example LNG20, progesterone. So such kind of intrauterine device available. These intrauterine device can be used to make the gap between two child, like 3 years, 5 years, or 7 years, these are available. Some people are using oral pills. These oral pills are combination of progesterone and estrogen hormone. High amount of progesterone in blood can stop to develop the follicles. So in such a way, follicles are not developed, and pregnant woman can't be pregnant. As a result, we can say up to 21 days these tablets are required, and there is big problem if a woman can left, if she forget, what she can do. She can take a tablet again up to 72 hours, but it should be effective if a woman can use. And if we did not like such kind of method, we use permanent method, these are surgical method. And there is two kind of method, tubectomy and vasectomy. Vasectomy can be used in male, whereas vasa deferentia can be cut and tear. So in such a way, during coitus, the semen can be released, but there is no sperm in semen. Only where secretion of seminal vesicles, prostate gland, copper gland can be available. Person can be feeling normal, just like in the real copulation, but there is no chance of pregnancy. In another word, this is also called male nasbandi. Or in case of another method that is female nasbandi or tubectomy, here fallopian duct can be cut and tagged by thread. So ovum can't be come in uterus and sperm can't be reached up to ampullae-squamous junction. In such a way, fertilization can be stopped and there is no chance to make the fertilization. Both methods are not reversible, so these methods can be used after deciding we need not take any chance of pregnancy or we need not to take child. So there are little side effects of these methods because just like copper tea or oral pills, sometimes these are having chemicals, especially steroids. So these steroids are harmful to woman body. Woman body can make mind swing, vomiting or obesity can be feel. Now these days it is good news, there is NDRI, National Drug Institute, Lucknow, branch of CSRI. It developed a non-steroid tablet that is Saheli. There is no side effect of Saheli. It is easily usable for women. The most important topic, next topic, that is medical termination of pregnancy. So what is the mean of medical of termination of pregnancy? When a doctor can examine the foetus is not survival condition, there is abnormal development, or the couple decide to not birth the child. So it is decided by doctor to make the termination with help of medical stores. So it is called medical termination of pregnancy. In India, MTP is legalized from 1971. And it can be used in such unwanted pregnancy, also in the rape cases, etc. And during such kind of the MTP, doctor, it is required to do such kind of method in under supervision of medical practitioner. And up to 12 weeks, there is very less chance to make such kind of negative effect to woman body. So doctor can be advised MTP up to 12 weeks. But in critical conditions, jury of two or more doctor can advise up to 24 weeks. It means up to 6 months. Generally, only 3 months baby can be withdrawn through MTP. So this is all about MTP. Next, our topic is sexual transmissible disease. So sexual transmissible disease is also written in your NCRT, just like sexual transmissible infection, STI. So when the male and female making coitus, if one partner having such kind of disease, gonorrhea or trichomoniasis, hepatitis B, AIDS, dialysis, genital warts, or genital herpes, etc. It is 100% chance to transfer the partner. So what we can do, we need to prevent such kind of the copulation or coitus in such periods, and we need to take treatment from the trained doctors. There is due to hesitation, it may possible we can contact such untrained people. Such people are known as jhola chhap doctor. So we need to prevent such kind of people because the people are taking much amount of money and there is no benefit, only harm. And in such time, there is no need to make the relationship between partners. And if it is required, we need to make use such barriers like condom. So there is less chance to transfer of disease. In such way, we can measure. So what we can do, avoid sex during such kind of the condition. We can make sex only one partner. And always use condom during the coitus. Go qualified doctor in case such kind of doubt can be happen. So if this is all about up to STI, sexual transmissible disease. Now our next topic, that is infertility. So regarding the infertility, what we are telling very simple. It is inability to produce children in spite of unprotected sexual coagulation. So why this happens? due to it may be due to failure of such structural ability of female or male, or low sperm count, low mobility of the sperm, or there is less chance of fertilization due to not working of acrosome. Many problems are there. So there is some technique are available to make the fertile in such couples. Such technique are called assisted reproductive technology. So these technology are included in following manners. I am explaining one by one. First is one in vitro fertilization. So what is the in vitro fertilization? I am telling you, in vitro fertilization is such kind of technique where what we can do, we can get ova from the female, we can get sperm from the male, and we can fertilize in test tube. Zygote can be formed, and if this zygote can be transferred in fallopian tube up to 8 cell stage, that is called zygote intra-fallopian transfer. If it can convert above than 8 cell, it can't be transferred into the fallopian tube, it can transfer in uterus. So that is called IUT, intrauterine transfer. And when we are transferring uterus, this is called embryo transfer, ET. Embryo, it is known as embryo transfer. And sometimes what will happen, if there is less mobility of the sperm, or there is ovum is not formed, we can get ovum through donor, and if this ovum can transfer to fallopian tube, and such kind transfer of ovum is called gamete intra-fallopian transfer. It may possible if sperm is not penetrating egg wall, we can inject sperm in ovum cytoplasm. That is called intracytoplasmic sperm. Sometimes artificial insemination also required, where artificial penis can inject sperm in uterus. So it is called IUI, intrauterine insemination, artificial. So all these techniques are very useful. By education, such kind of people can use these techniques to make fertility, and to provide such kind of the doctors or such kind of jhula chhap doctor. So student, please see this video and comment your videos. If any question you ask me, thank you.